I think it was a decision coming from the Meralco Bolts to just fight fire with fire because there was nothing else working for them. We know that coming into this series, naka-focus sa depensa itong magkabilang koponan. They are both outstanding defensive teams. But when you have Alain Maliksi not being able to see a lot of minutes because you are worried about kung sino yung de-depensahan niya, can he match up with someone like Calvin Abueva, for example? Can he match up with one of the speedier guards with a Paul Leon defense? Then, malilimitahan din yung opportunities niya to take shots. If he can't stay in the game for a while, then hindi mo ma-maximize talaga yung galing nitong si Alain Maliksi. He has not scored in double digits for this entire series up until this explosion. And
right,
those
diba,
two big threes.
Lang siya the other day?
Exactly.
Is it 2 points?
Exactly.
Right? Yeah, yeah.
In the other game that they won, he had 9 points. That was his biggest output of the series so far. And those 2 3-point shots late in the ball game, no, to just seal the win, were huge. Were humongous for Meralco. Kasi fouled out na itong si Chris Newsom at that stage of the ball game.
Well, the same with the case with Alain Maliksi, who had 2 points. Ganun din sila Pinto and Newsom in the previous game. Yeah. Right? Although Newsom did have 11 points, but it ain't 24. And then, of course, Pinto also had a pretty good game today.
Yung nagiging problema kasi ng Meralco Boom is that they thought that they were able to make the necessary adjustments in terms of their offense. Because in the PBA bubble, there were certain spots where nothing happened for them on offense. Their solutions were Mac Bello in trading for him for Baseramir and drafting Alvin Pasaol. Mm-hmm. They were hoping that those two could provide the punch from the second unit, which is not happening. Which now puts a lot of pressure on guys like Chris Newsom and Nart Pinto specifically kasi si Aaron Black hindi pa rin makapaglaro because of an injured hand. It puts a lot of pressure on those three to really push the offense for the Bolts.
Of course, when you look at the way the Bolts performed in general, it felt like, you know, they really needed that second half kick to finally get past a Magnolia team who felt like they were doing the right thing. So we have to also give credit to the almost perfect game of a certain Mark Barroca. Mm-hmm. But you know, it's that new father energy again that's running through him. And it was huge stuff, Carla. Mm-hmm.
Yep, 9 of 10 from the field, 0 turnovers. Another good game from Mark Barroca coming off a 2-point, 1 of 9 game nung natalo sila, no, to back-to-back big performances from him. But for Meralco, napakalaking bagay din, Pao, yung return nitong si Raymond Almazan.
Yeah.
It's different when you have a big man like him coming back because it just gives you a little more confidence that you will be more competitive in rebounding. He was, I think, a plus 17 in about 30 minutes. So that is a big deal for Meralco.
Other than Mark Barroca, though, there are some other standout performances today, even in a losing effort, mm-hmm. Carlo.
Oh, Calvin Abueva did
course,
well.
Yeah.
And then, of course, you have to expect it like you know, every game na magagawa ng double-double itong Sian Sangala.
Yeah.
Shoot 50% from the field. It was I think, one of the best games of the series because it was pushed up until the end. Magnolia kept on fighting. They got a late steal, gave themselves an opportunity to tie the contest, just could not get the big shots that would, you know, win that game for them.
So the double-double of Sangala was expected. Mm-hmm. Calvin Abueva, his clutch performance there. Question is though, what happened to Paul Lee in your opinion? Ooh. Was it a case of Meralco just clamping down and doing the right things, or Paul Lee just having a rare off game for the Magnolia fans?
I think he had an off game, not because of his shooting, because it was Mark Barroca carrying the offense for the guards. Hindi naman kasing pwedeng sabay-sabay pumotok lahat ng guarda nitong Magnolia because, you know, Gio Halalon also did well from the bench. I think he also scored double digits with 12. So Paul Lee, I think he struggled with his turnovers. Maybe he did not get into the rhythm that he wanted because of a couple of early errors that he committed. And if you remember, he also had a tough foul against Alain Maliksi, giving him 3 free throws. And, you know, it just speaks about the flow of the game. Maybe Paul Lee did not have it. But if you're Meralco, you will be worried about that guy coming into Game 6 because rarely does he have a couple of bad games in a row.
Yeah, yeah. Couple of comebacks in the last couple of games. Diba? Yeah. Parang baliktaran yata yung nangyari in these last 2 fourth quarters. Meralco making the chase, kapos. Magnolia making the chase, kapos. But still another chance for game number 6. What are your thoughts on that and how are we looking at that game?
It's very difficult to judge which team will win this ball game. Kasi palaging dikit yung laban. As I said, they're very similar in terms of what they want to do on the floor. So now, I think the point of interest is how Coach Chito Victolero will try to get the ball away from Alain Maliksi. Mm-hmm. And if they're successful, it will be very difficult for Meralco to stay alive. But they did it in Game 5. So if they can get Alain Maliksi going, they could very well force a do-or-die matchup against Magnolia.
You know, we touched on Raymond Almazan a while ago, and all eyes will again be on him because he's still recovering from an injury. And it felt like today he did his job, but you could see that maybe he wasn't at full speed. Do you feel that the next game will see an even healthier Almazan and could expect more from him?
I think the biggest thing about the performance of Almazan was the 30 minutes that he played.
Yeah,
absolutely. I mean, if he is not anywhere close to being 100%, I don't think Coach Norman would trust him with 30 minutes in the ball game. So I think he's very close to being, you know, healthy, and you know, expect more from Raymond Almazan in the next game.
Am I allowed to ask you what your pulse is for game number 6, Carlo?
Because
it
might factor into my play calling. I would plead the fifth answer.
Are you calling the game or I'm calling the game? I don't know, but I think I'm calling one of the games. So
we'll settle that at the break.
Walang predictions muna, okay? All right.